Hi everyone, my name is Marian Deboatinda and I'm from the University of Namibia, and I'm going to present about an e-complaint system, a semi-structured e-forum at university. Universities use complaint forums to provide students with a platform to complain about issues happening around campus. So this basically assists in preventing students' dissatisfaction and improve services rendered to students. Currently at the University of Namibia, there is a complaint forum known as the Student Lecturer Forum that allows the students to air their complaints about issues happening on campus and allow lecturers and university management to address those issues. However, lately, there has been a low student turn-up. There's a need to investigate an alternative solution, and technology could be employed. So according to the literature, e-participation has drawn attention in education. However, it has focused more on collaboration to improve effective teaching and learning. So studies on e-participation focus more on improving effective teaching and learning and not on solving students' complaint about academic and non-academic issues on campus. So e-forums are divided into two categories, structured and unstructured forums, of which the information is laid in either a structured or an unstructured manner. A structured e-forum participants are allowed to annotate their post with a semantic that properly represent and identify the content of their text entries in the e-forum. And they can either be synchronous or asynchronous. In synchronous structure e-forum, the receiver to whom the post is directed to is required to be online at the moment the message is sent, and interaction requires simultaneous participation and occurs in real time. On the contrary, asynchronous e-forum do not require all participants to be online simultaneously for discussions to occur, thus giving the user greater flexibility to differentiate complaints to offer suitable responses. This study designed, developed, and conducted usability testing on a semi-structured e-forum known as a UNAM e-forum. So the main objective was supported by three sub-objectives, whereby the first one was to identify challenges faced by students regarding the current student lecture forum, identify requirements, design, and develop an e-forum to encourage student participation, and test the stability of the developed UNAM e-forum among students at UNAM. So the study employed a qualitative research approach and was divided into four phases. In the first phase, the requirements gathering challenges that led to the low turn-up at the student lecture forum at UNAM were identified, and then the requirements for an e-forum were ascertained. So the study was conducted for 11 months, and a convenient sampling technique was employed where an online questionnaire was used for data collection. The sample population consisted of 50 students registered in the School of Computing in UNAM, and 90 participants responded to the online questionnaire, which consisted of a combination of closed and open-ended questions. So before the distribution of the questionnaire, students were informed about their rights to withdraw from the study at any time, and anonymity was emphasized. Results from the questionnaire found that students don't attend forums due to time, where 30 students indicated that they normally have assignments and tests, further mentioning that they would rather use that time to complete their assignments or study for for their test. 20 participants mentioned that questions were not always answered during the forum, as some staff members and top management were not present. And then results from the questionnaire suggested the development of an asynchronous e-forum, as students indicated that they would prefer a platform that would allow them to lay complaints at any time, anywhere. So these slides depict the basic flowchart of the system, whereby the user logs in, and then upon successfully logging in, they are presented with the menu, which consists of four options. So this slide depicts the homepage of a student. So basically, there is a navigation bar, and then there is a part whereby the admin can reply to the student. And then, you know, like there's also a dashboard that consists of the different categories. So when a student posts a complaint, they then actually select the category where they are posting or where they are complaining about. Okay, so this slide presents the user interface for the administrator. So the administrator, which is the student student vice president, can is the only one who's allowed to delete and respond to the complaints. So the student representative council vice president was made as the administrator, because currently at the physical forum, the vice president is actually the one that they facilitate the discussion between the students and the lecturers or management. Okay, so the UNAM eForum underwent unit testing upon completion, and then afterwards usability testing was conducted as well. So during the usability testing, only 15 participants were involved, because it was the time of the exam and students were reluctant to participate in this study. So the usability testing was done using the SAS questionnaire, which of course is a self-administered questionnaire that is widely used to evaluate the usability of user interfaces. So based on the score, the system actually scored 85, and based on that score, the 85 entails that the system was perceived as easy to learn, efficient to use, easy to remember, has few errors, and is pleasing to the users. So the use of e-complaints in university can significantly contribute to their reputation and performances. So the implementation of the UNAM eForum offers benefits such as enabling the university to provide quality services to its students. So a university that offers quality education contributes to the Sustainable Development Goal 4, which of course advocate for quality education and promote lifelong learning opportunities for all. So a university with an effective complaint handling system will be in a position to resolve students' complaint quickly, and as a result, students will be happy to be affiliated with such a university. Hence, the university will be exalted, and this will have a positive effect on the university's performance. In conclusion, this study investigated the design, development, and tested a semi-structured e-forum to make the complaint process easy for students at the University of Namibia. The rationale for implementing the e-forum is for students' complaint to be managed effectively and timelessly. Although UNAM has a student lecture forum, the study found that staff members did not address the students' complaints on time, as some were not present during the forums, and this basically contributed to the students' low turnout. So according to the literature, it was learned that e-forums were mostly used to improve students' academic writing skills and to enhance education delivery. Thus, there is a gap in investigating the use of e-forums for complaint. So, the implementation of an effective UNAM e-forum will contribute to the university's rendering quality services, and then for future work, the UNAM e-forum should be implemented for use by all UNAM campuses countrywide and tested among different faculty at the university. So this study recommends the integration of a chatbot into the proposed UNAM e-forum for quick and timely responses. So I thank you for listening to the presentation, and